Listening Library presents When is a Planet Not a Planet? The Story of Pluto by Elaine Scott. Read for you by Pete Larkin. Introduction. My very eager mother just served us 9 pizzas. A silly sentence, yet school children have memorized it for years because it helps them remember the planets in our solar system. The first letter of every word stands for a planet in the order of how close it is to the sun. My very eager mother just served us 9 pizzas. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto. Mercury is the planet closest to the sun, and tiny Pluto is the farthest away. That is, until recently. Pluto is still there, of course, along with the planets, asteroids, comets, meteors, and bits of space rock and ice. Pluto is part of our solar system. Pluto and all those other objects orbit or travel around the sun. However, on August 24, 2006, the International Astronomical Union, IAU, a group of individual astronomers and astronomical societies from around the world, made an announcement. They declared that Pluto was not a planet. Suddenly, my very eager mother just served us 9 pizzas didn't work anymore, because now there are only 8 major planets orbiting the sun. Perhaps someone will create a new sentence to help us remember their names and order. Names are important, but they are not the only things to know about the planets. Learning how planets form, where they are located, and what they are like is the kind of activity that makes science exciting and fun. 1. The Wanderers. From the beginning of time, people have paid attention to objects in the night sky. Our ancient ancestors studied the moon. They watched it grow from a tiny crescent-shaped sliver to a round ball of light, then slip back to a tiny sliver again. As they watched it, they began to mark off time. One full cycle of the moon became 1 month. They noticed other things moving in the night sky: stars, comets, meteors, planets, which filled them with wonder and amazement. So they carved pictures of the planets, the sun, the moon, and stars onto rocks, and they painted pictures of them on the walls of their caves. These rock carvings and paintings still exist today. Some are over 20,000 years old. Around 1000 BC, the Greek people became very good astronomers, scientists who study matter in outer space. The Greeks noticed that some of the objects in the night sky were brighter than others. They noticed that these objects moved from east to west across a background of stars that seemed to stay still. What were these things? The Greeks called them planetes, which in their language means wanderers. Our word planet comes from that Greek word. Why did the planets wander? In the ancient world, some people thought the planets were gods walking across the heavens. Others, however, wanted a more scientific answer. 2. Some early astronomers. Ptolemy was a Greek astronomer who lived from AD 100 to 179. He was one of the first to describe how planets wander. Ptolemy said planets moved in an orbit, a curved path that one object travels along as it revolves around another. Anytime you run around and around something in a circle, you are orbiting it. Ptolemy believed that Earth was at the center of our universe, so he claimed that the planets, the stars, the sun, and the moon all orbited around Earth. For the next 1400 years, people believed Ptolemy was right, but we know now that he was wrong.
3. Space Fact. Ptolemy was one of the most important astronomers of his time. His theory that the sun revolves around Earth lasted for 1,400 years. It is often called the geocentric theory. Geo is Greek for Earth.
A Polish astronomer, Nicholas Copernicus, came up with a different theory. Copernicus said it was the Sun, not Earth, that was at the center of our solar system. He said all the planets, including Earth, orbited the Sun. Copernicus lived from 1473 to 1543. During his lifetime, many people were afraid of his new ideas. Few accepted his theory about the sun. A group of Christians who followed the teachings of Martin Luther and called themselves Lutherans were particularly upset with Copernicus. In fact, when Copernicus asked Andreas Osiander, 1498 to 1552, who happened to be a Lutheran pastor, to publish his theories about Earth's orbit, Osiander changed the preface to the book. He wrote that Copernicus's ideas were just a hypothesis, a scientific prediction based on observations, not fact. But within 100 years, things began to change.
Space fact. Copernicus's theory that the Sun is at the center of the solar system is called the heliocentric theory. Helios is Greek for sun. Copernicus's ideas are so important, they are often referred to as the Copernican Revolution.
In 1608, a Dutchman named Hans Lippershey, 1570 to 1619, invented the telescope by accident. Lippershey was an optician, someone who makes eyeglasses. One afternoon, he was working with his lenses, and he held one in front of another. When he looked through both at the same time, Lippershey noticed that objects appeared larger and closer than they really were. Since it was difficult to hold the two lenses apart for any length of time, Lippershey put them on either end of a long tube, and the telescope was invented. At first, the new invention was called a spyglass. The Dutch military used it to look far out to sea, checking for any enemy ships that might be approaching Holland. However, when an Italian astronomer named Galileo Galilei got a spyglass of his own, he made improvements to it and looked up to the heavens, not out to sea. Galileo, as he is known, lived from 1564 to 1642. Working with his telescope, Galileo discovered that Jupiter has moons orbiting it, just as our moon orbits Earth. He also discovered that the Milky Way is not a smear of white in the night sky, but is made up of individual stars, billions of them. Galileo agreed with Copernicus. He said the Sun was the center of our solar system, not Earth. However, many people were still not ready for new ideas. In fact, most people at the time thought Galileo's theories went against the stories in the Bible that seemed to put Earth at the center of the universe. In those days, in Catholic countries like Italy, the Church made the laws, and the Church punished people who broke its laws. Galileo was put under house arrest. Others who agreed with him were punished, and some were even burned at the stake.
Space fact. Those who put Galileo on trial would not...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.